My name is Amy Kernick, and I am chair of the CAEP Rural, Remote, and Small Urban Section. Since the last AGM in November, our section has been busy. We have welcomed a new vice chair, Dr. Dan Eichmeier, and updated our terms of reference to reflect our group values. Of note, the name of the section has changed to include remote, and we have broadened the definition of rural medicine to be more inclusive. We welcome all CAEP members with significant experience or interest in rural medicine to join the section. Along with the CAEP board, our section is also striving to improve our awareness of equity, diversity, and inclusion, and making this central to everything that we do. Members of our section have been busy as representatives on various committees, including the Heart and Stroke Foundation, the Rural Roadmap Implementation Committee, the CFPC Working Group on EM exam eligibility criteria, and several CAEP groups, including the CPD, Membership, and POCUS committees, the Academic Section, the Future of Emergency Medicine Committee and New Task Force, and the CAEP Board of Directors. We are grateful for the opportunity to add a rural perspective to these important groups. Some recent accomplishments from the past year include our participation in the Rural Roadmap Implementation Committee's report on patient transfers, published in April of this year. We also hosted our first Rural CAEP National Grand Rounds on April 14th, where we discussed cutting-edge advancements in digital medicine that are changing the way emergency medicine care is delivered, especially in rural and remote regions. This has sparked further conversations and partnerships, as well as a networking group. If you're interested, please check out the CAEP website for the free and open access recording of our presentation and a link to the Slack group. Perhaps our greatest success of this year was the change made to the criteria for the examination of added competence in emergency medicine practice eligible route. Changes made back in 2019 by the CFPC were highly detrimental for rural physicians, and through advocacy, partnership, and the creation of a working group, we successfully fought for more inclusive criteria. Our ongoing projects include working in collaboration with others at CAEP, the SRPC, and the Canadian Red Cross on advocacy for a national license, creating a list of alternative training programs and resources for rural clinicians, and designing a national health human resource survey for emergency medicine information that we hope will be valuable for advocacy regarding staffing shortages and training needs. We're currently seeking research partners on this endeavor, so please contact us with interest. For more information about our section and ongoing projects, please check out our page on the CAEP website.